हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। सपोज वन टेबल नो प्राइमरी की एंड रिक्वायरमेंट टू डिलीट एंड फाइंड द डुप्लीकेट रिकॉर्ड इन ए डैट टेबल विच नो प्राइमरी की। सो टुडे विल डिस्कस डिलीट ए डुप्लीकेट रिकॉर्ड्स फ्रॉम ए एसक्यूएल टेबल विदाउट ए प्राइमरी की एंड व्हाट इज रो नंबर फंक्शन। What is row number function? The row number function is a window function that assigns a sequential integer number to each row in the query result set. The output of the query result, you can assign a sequential integer number like 1, 2, 3, and 4. Syntax row number function. Row number over partition by order by clause. Partition by means divide the result set produced by the from clause. The partition by clause is optional. If you omit it, the whole result set is treated as a single partition. And order by clause sort the row in each partition. If you are using row number function, you have to pass order by clause is required. Please like and subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon to never miss SQL Server interesting video. Let's connect with SQL Server Management Studio to show you how to delete a duplicate record from a SQL table without a primary key and how to use row number function. First, we are going to learn row number function. If you are able to understand the usage of a row number function, it is very easy to understand how to delete a record if the table no primary key. You can see here very simple script to get all system and user database. You just run this script, you can see that all the user system databases and with recovery model description, but you can see in that result set row number is a missing. So let's add the row number. So this is the syntax for the row number. You after select you have to add row number function over, let's add it here, select row number over and close the close it. In this you can pass partition by or order by clause, or you can pass all partition by and order by clause. I am going to pass here only order by clause on name column. So let's add here over by order by name as ascending as row number function. Now I have added a new column name as a row number which will add in this query result set. You can run this query and you can see here new column added with row number with all sequence numbers. So this is the use of row number function. Now I am going to use a partition by on recovery model description. If you add partition by clause on a recovery model description column, it will restart the numbering when the recovery model description value gets changed from full to simple. So once it get a change, sequence number will get a change. Let's add here partition by. Let's copy this here and add partition by and column recovery model description. Okay.
recovery model description order by name ascending as a row number. After adding partition by on a recovery model description, you can see the complete query. Select row number over partition by column recovery model description, order by column name ascending as a row number. Recovery model from sys database. Let's run this script. You can see here the result set. Row number, name and sample. So this is recovery model description simple. So its row number is 1. Here recovery model description changes to full, so its row number is 1. Again you can see here recovery model description is changed same as a full, so here 2. And here you can see all these are full recovery model description, so sequence here 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 and 6 here. Now you can see here recovery model description again changed to simple. Here first be marked 1. Now second sequence for the simple is 2. So how its partition work? If you adding a partition by clause on the recovery model description column, will restart the numbering when the recovery model description value get changed. So now we going to learn how to delete a duplicate record if table not containing any identity and primary key. You can see this table as student in roll number column, it is not a identity and primary key and containing duplicate value. So let's remove the duplicate value from a student table. To delete a duplicate record, you have to add here row number over and order by roll number ascending ID. So this will help you to the sequence the result set. You can see here now result set is a got sequence with unique value. Now I am going to add here partition by roll number, a student name and a phone number I added here. Let's run this. You can see here I am added partition by in roll number, a student name and a phone number. It help restart the numbering when the roll number, a student name, phone value get changed. Means if duplicate number will get a change, if no duplicate then number will be 1 only. You can see here this record roll number 1 bin and this record have 1, and you can see this is duplicate, so here number got changed to 2. This partition by 1, it means this value is not a duplicate value. So you can find the duplicate. So you can see here this value is a unique and this value is a duplicate. You can see here this is a duplicate value because this value is available here. So this how you can find the duplicate value. You can see this ID mark as 1, it means this is the unique value. This mark as a 2, it means this is the duplicate value. Now you able to find the duplicate value. Now requirement to delete the duplicate value. So I am going to close this one and this one also, and going to add here a student, where a student ID greater than 1, it will get deleted. And here I am going to add a delete command. Delete a student from a student dot ID greater than 1. It will delete all the duplicate data. Let's run it. You can see it's deleted all the duplicate records. You can verify by running this student table. Select star from table a student. Let's run it. Now you can see the result said not containing any duplicate value.